Hello, I'm not rushed. That orange bloke who basically tells people to be more original, yet is just a base wearing agape. Okay then. So today, we're going to talk about abilities. And yes, we'll be touching on the unholy, hellish concept we know only as demon forms. But, as you, the ever-observant viewer may note, the title doesn't mention anything about demon forms. However, I would like to note the inclusion of demon and angel forms as a major part of this video has a purpose, as these forms are usually used in characters with very Dragon Ball-esque abilities. As to why I didn't mention them in the title? Simple. I couldn't think of a good pun for them, so the current title will have to do. As said in the previous episode, we would be covering demon forms in due time. However, in all honesty, I do not believe it's a worthy time to perform a super in-depth analysis of this kind of form. However, I will certainly mention it at ad. Firstly, for this category of character cliches, woe that alliteration was pretty slick, we have the timeless super form, or mega form, or full power form, or whatever you want to call it. It is a strange beast that goes by many names. However, it is easy to spot. Oftentimes they only rear their bland head when a character is about to die, which in itself is a problem. These forms don't really have any actual reason to exist. I mean, again, they don't add anything to a character, and often are just a glorified recolor with enhanced stats or completely overpowered abilities. Oftentimes, they come in with an over-the-top effect, be it an explosion, some kind of massive light or a thingy, or a simple line of dialogue. Now, the big problem with this is that it's so overdone, it's gotten to the point where we expect SN characters to have a super form. Now, are all super forms bad? No. It just depends on how they're done. It's mainly the meaningless recolors. Two examples of this done well would be Jex, owned by Malone, and Tyke, owned by Jay. Jex, though it is technically an angel form, does switch color, meaning that the usually skin part of his body is white-tricity, and the usually white-tricity part of his body is skin. And with Tyke, he merges with his hammer. And in this form, he actually gains some pretty unique abilities, such as darkness wings or using his hammer's spikes as projectiles. But wait. You, the intelligent viewer who's watched my other videos, may say, Rush has a super form, doesn't he? Well, no, not exactly. Ether focus isn't really a form, as it doesn't do anything to actually changing physical aspects of his character, bar the right eye glowing. But considering that the right eye is actually a gemstone, rather than an actual eye, this point is debatable at best. Ether focus is actually the process of Rush tapping into the ether source to temporarily gain more available ether, as a cost. He focuses less on the battle, lowering reaction time. Secondly, we have demon and angel forms. Now, I can't really touch on these too much without sounding like a broken record. At this point, it's practically a cliche to complain about them, so I'll make it quick. To start, they don't really add anything to a character, especially not angel forms, they basically add wings and a halo. Angel forms are bland and cliche, however, in the grand scheme of things, they're not really that much of a problem, compared to demons, scarves or elements. They're pretty rare, but are still pretty cringe-inducing when they show up. Again, they often show up right before a character supposedly dies, although in a bizarre way, that sort of makes sense. And just wipe out their opponent. It's not really that fun to watch. Now, demons, I don't particularly want to talk too much about demons today. I'm saving this for a video just for them. But I'll briefly go over a few points. Again, they rarely add anything to a character, and only show up when a character is about to die, just like angels and supers. Also, they are nearly always portrayed as taking the person over. For once I'd like to see the character and his demon actually work together. Finally, we have the most obvious point. They all look the same. Literally all that most people do is add spikes and horns to the normal body. I suppose it's nothing if not recognizable. Alright, now, I'll get to the titular subject. I just want to say that, well, I've noticed this one a lot over the 3 odd years I've been in the community. Right. Let's chat about Dragon Ball's abilities. To start, let's quickly run over just what this encompasses. Forms, which I've already gone over, as well as flight, teleportation, energy beams. So, let's talk about flight. Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No, it's
every stick mode's character ever.
In our community, flight is generally seen as a sort of passive ability, usually used to conveniently negate the awful power of gravity. When they use flight, it almost always ends up in an aerial fistfight that could be easily replicated on ground, and be just as effective, maybe even less bland. Flight, in a way, being such a common ability, entraps creativity, in a sense, because, at this point, not having flight is an utter disadvantage. Being utterly landlocked can leave a character completely helpless against an aerial assault, even if they have projectiles of some sort. Of course, there are ways to simulate this power without actually being able to fly, potentially via some sort of climbing aptitude or increased jumping ability, or maybe a Batman-styled glide, or swinging apparatus. The choices for countering flight are very vast, yet rather untapped. Secondly, we have teleportation, which almost always leads to a character teleporting into the air and firing a massive beam. Teleportation in of itself is an over-the-top power, which is generally rather broken in a fight. They just teleport away from damage, and teleport behind their opponent, and punch them. Teleportation also pretty much always, and I mean always, has the same sound effect. This one. As said, teleportation is rather, for lack of a better word, overpowered. The ability to avoid damage entirely, escape grabs and traps, and strike back, before vanishing into the shadows from whence you came. It can lead to utterly one-sided fights, which can quickly become stale, since there's no real way to counter teleportation. A few ideas for teleportation alternatives would be portals, allowing a character to get from one place to the next, but limiting it between two specific points. Another example would be flash stepping, the ability to dash a short distance at immense speed. This would be similar to short-range teleportation, only lacking the crucial ability to escape grabs and traps. Another idea is what I call checkpoint setting, the idea of setting a specific place to teleport back to, maybe in the form of a visible afterimage, maybe as an orb of sorts. It's up to you. Another variation of checkpoint setting would be Sandman-style weapon teleportation, the ability to teleport to a specific item, usually your weapon. As for me, I'm personally using a method other than these ones. The idea of ether projection is that Rush sends an ether clone forward, before being able to instantly take its place. However, Rush himself cannot move whilst the ether clone is active. A risk or reward situation, if you will. Lastly, energy beams. Again, energy beams, ki blasts. Remember how I said that forms only really come out when a character nearly dies? Yeah. These massive lasers are most often the reason behind that near death. And it's usually a beam that's larger than the characters themselves. Yeah, I'm not sure that's how energy works. I don't think that a character can store that amount of energy, and still have some left after that major beam. Guess that's why they're always tired or something after it. Now, ki blasts, or energy blasts, are genuinely a pretty standard ability. They're a clean and tidy way of providing your original character with a projectile weapon. If bows, crossbows, yumi, guns, lasers, throwing knives, darts, shuriken, boomerangs, javelins, spears, tomahawks, hand axes, light brands, rune swords, flamberges or levin swords are all out of the question. This convenience is probably the reason they're so common. However, There are many other potential alternatives to ki blasts, such as any physical variant, such as arrows or bullets, or even in their, well, magical, if you will, variants. You could have waves, fields, orbs, projections, flames, thunderbolts, icicles, chunks of ground, although that would be getting into the elemental abilities, which is a discussion for another day. And these projectile blasts could be used for so much more than just sheer damage. They could be used for freezing or slowing a foe, knocking them out, buffing or nerfing them, burning, stunning, fatiguing, or even reversing. Heck, you could even fire ability cancelling orbs of negative energy, if you want. I know this paragraph has been particularly ramble, and I must give my apologies, but these lists just show that there's so much choice and possibility when it comes to projectiles, and the fact that this potential remains untapped is just a crying tragedy, if you ask me. At the end of the day, these are just my views, and, of course, you all are entitled to yours, whether we agree or not. But, in summary, forms are but a crutch to lean on. When the going gets tough, if you, viewer, can break out of that crutch, you'd be opening yourself up to lots of potential new directions for your character, and I can talk, I used to have a lot of forms. 3. If memory serves. They've since been incorporated into the canon of the character, and have become their own individual people. Allowing Rush to develop as a character, without Zen, Rune and Waste weighing down on him. As for DBZ abilities, again, they're very safe, if you will. They've blank abilities that have so many forgotten variations on them, and that just makes me sad. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this, glorified monologue, I suppose. And I would appreciate it if you let me know if you all want another one, and give your suggestions on what it should be about. Now, that's enough social interaction for one day. I'm going to go wallow in my sad corner over the amount of untapped abilities there are. Good day.